I'm from Tri-Cities, Washington. Grew up in a small town, like the last generation before the internet. Having the impulse to go into the arts in Tri-Cities was challenging to begin with, but once you find it, it's totally there. I knew I wanted to be an actress. I knew I wanted to be a performer. I knew I wanted to sing. I knew I wanted to create. I didn't really see a job title that encompassed all of those. And whenever people asked, do you want to choose screen or do you want to choose stage, I would always just be like, how many things can you possibly choose? I want to do whatever they're going to let me get away with. I think this is just the best thing ever. Tri-Cities definitely was such a beautiful place to grow up, but I had massive culture shock when I got to Los Angeles to go to college, and massive culture shock again when I moved to New York. But I feel like now I could go anywhere. This is Guinness. I went to USC, and I did not major in acting. I wanted to study lots of other things too. I had a lot of wide interests, which scared me a lot because, in the entertainment industry, especially, you're kind of expected to have a super kind of narrow focus that you always knew from day one. This is what you wanted. And mine was a lot wider than that. So I went to USC, went to film school because I liked studying storytelling. And I felt like, especially in the modern age, the video storytelling or cinematic storytelling was kind of the way it was going. So I went to USC, went to film school, and then I had my first boyfriend and I got my heart broken for the first time. And I was like, God damn, I miss theater. So I went back to do it as a hobby first. Because, I tried out for everything at USC and I got called back for all of it and I didn't get any shit. I didn't get anything freshman year. Not the acapella groups, not the dance company, not the show, not, and for someone who'd been, kind of a big fish in a small pond, that was shitty.
Yeah.
But, I got better. It was kind of, at that point, I was like, well, shit, this is what I gotta do, and this is how I gotta make it work. I competed in this thing called LA's Next Great Stage Star.
Some girls have diamonds to wear, feelings to share.
Which is now like 10 years old, and it was kind of the only fertile ground for, musical theater kids in Los Angeles where you could really hop into the very small but kind of exclusive pond of working actors. And I came at it with such a different attitude. For the first time ever, instead of just like, oh, what am I doing? How do I be, this is what I'm doing and this is how I'm going to style my hair. For the first time, I really thought about the strategy of like what was needed. And they were looking for someone who was going to nail it all the time. And they were looking for someone who, could be chosen by everyone. And I thought, I'm going to be at a mass disadvantage because all my family is out of town. All of my family is in Washington State. All my people who would come out, to support. And it was partially audience voting. I thought was shit, I'm gonna have to make other people's moms vote for me too. I had all the songs chosen and then I threw them all out when I was flying home for Christmas because I needed to be better moving forward. I needed just to be better. Objectively, I was doing fine, I needed to be better. I was like, how am I doing better? And I put on my headphones at the Seattle airport and I missed my flight because I was so focused on finding songs on YouTube.
Huh.
But it was right then that I found the song that I sang and I won with, which was How Lucky Can You Get from Funny Lady.
When I see the chauffeur, think I give him a raise. How lucky can you get?
But I didn't do it the Barber way. I actually found a Cheetah Rivera version on YouTube. she does this amazing change halfway through. And I had been really learning like what your acting had been, what you can do with it. And so I just took it even farther.
How lucky can you be? How lucky can you wow? How lucky can you get? But odie, 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 ain't I got fun? But odie, odie, I'm the luckiest. Satin on my shoulders and a smile on my lip. How lucky can you get?
I made a huge breakthrough in that competition, just as a performer, and you know, trusting myself and getting smart about how to execute. And then I won.
In my circle of friends, someone I am crazy for.
And then I got my agent, and then the audition after that was to play an opera singing French poodle named Chanel for my equity card.
Okay.
And they were doing Into the Woods senior year at USC. And I kind of think I was gonna play the witch, you know, I had it in my heart that I was gonna play it.
Mm-hmm.
To play a poodle for my equity card. Sometimes you gotta make those calls. And it was right after that that Bring It On started talking to me. My senior year of college, it was January when I first went out for it. And it was July when I booked it. And I flew back and forth to New York on my own dollar, which they tell you not to do. But I was like, you're gonna pry this from my cold dead hands. Because I felt like I was someone. I knew they were looking for someone like me. And I knew that it was my job to not screw it up and just walk in and show them that. And I'd never thought of an audition like that before. And then Bring It On happened and everything changed. Tour first, moved to New York, opened on Broadway, started getting, you know, emails of a higher caliber. Just changed the whole game. All of a sudden I was in the major leagues. Truthfully, even then I was like super, super happy to be working, but you know, I wasn't very artistically fulfilled. And I know that's a luxury, but it was a, you know, I'd reached a level and a level of support and network and people where I thought, you know, what would I do if I could do anything? And I wanted to sing and write and create my own stories. So 3 years later, three shows later, If Then closes, and I think, okay, I'm gonna do this on my own. I'd done during If Then, and in between my second and third shows, I started writing with a dance music group called Trillium. That was amazing, and it taught me so much. And then, you know, like I'm learning, things do, things, pendulum swings, and it was working for a while, and it stopped working. Trillium was the first time I really started allowing myself to write and be a writer publicly, stand up as a creator instead of just an actress. And I struggle with confidence all the time, and then I just have to decide that something else is more important than the fear. And the thing I want to do, and the people I want to tell the story to and with and for, is more important than whatever stupid insecurities I have. I think that's something that everybody fights, though.
Action.
Action Jackson.
Action Jackson.
The Jackson Massive is the new band. It's me, Brian Ripps, and Gabe Cummins.
Sleeping with myself, spending time mostly alone.
When I met Brian in January of this year, I was working on, you know, a solo project. Was planning on moving to LA because things were slow here, and you know, I feel like I don't always have the answers, but you know where forward is. very quickly I was like, oh, what I want to do is sing, write, and perform. And the Jackson Maxim has this momentum that I haven't experienced before. I think it's the best writing I've ever done. I know it's the best writing I've ever done. And it's because of the collaboration with these two people. Brian is, you know, 10 years as a guitarist, and Gabe's, you know, 15, 17 years as a professional musician, teacher, writer, producer person. And I feel so enabled by these people to embrace maybe the creator portions that I have so much less confidence in, but I'm so, so excited by. You know, on Broadway, you take a text that you know, you hope, you can trust. You know, West Side Story, just breathe in the words and breathe it out, like it's gonna be great. When you're the one writing it, I think there's a lot more questions of, what am I writing? Who am I writing this for? What do I mean to say with this? I have such a love for the art forms of music and performance that I only want to do it very, 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 very well or smart or with something to contribute. Because I love it so much. Now, in terms of the Jackson Massive, I am acting as producer, PR team, marketing strategist. I shoot our videos, I edit our videos, post. I really feel excited though, because it kind of feels like that modern job that I was thinking about when I was younger, which is a combination of writing and performing and with the right team. And you know, something that I feel passionate about is creating positive communities and role models, because I just don't think you could ever have enough of those in the world. I'm getting pretty good at being alone. I'm getting pretty good at being alone. Just me and my cell phone. Damn, girl. So what I love about the Jackson Massive is we're a circus. We're a traveling circus. We have many tents. You're invited. And you never know what show is going to happen. I joke that we're like shoestring budget rock stars. Like, this is what I always dreamed of. I thought I'd be much richer. But so far, so great. I think radio music should be better. And I would love to try it. I feel like the Jackson Massive is that project and is that tent that I feel like we can build under for hopefully decades. Hadn't even said in the sky, then go and catch your eye. I'm true. Broadway is a gift to me that I never thought was actually gonna happen. And then it did, and then that and those people opened my mind to thinking, wow, fucking God. How many people can I take with me? What will they let me get away with? Take me back to the night. We were so unless you're fighting. You would tell me things like, baby, I can't wait to see you.